everyone. In this video, you will find explanation of Act 2, Scene 2. The scene takes place in Venice, in a street. This scene is divided into three sections. In the first section, you will find Lancelot Gobbo, who is the comedian of the play and also Shylock's servant, debating with his conscience whether he should leave service of Shylock and join Bassanio. In the second section, we find Lancelot requesting Bassanio to join him as his servant. And in the third section, we find Gratiano requesting Bassanio to let him accompany him to Belmont. So the scene opens with a speech of Lancelot. Now let's begin with the detailed explanation of the scene. Lancelot: certainly my conscience will serve me to run from this Jew, my master. Obviously my conscience will not prevent me to run away from Jew, the Shylock, my master. The fiend is at mine elbow and tempts me, saying to me, Gobbo, Lancelot Gobbo, good Lancelot, or good Gobbo, or good Lancelot Gobbo, use your legs, take the start, run away. The fiend, that is devil, stands beside me and tempts me by saying to me that good Lancelot Gobbo, make a good start and run away from the Jew. My conscience says, no, take heed, honest Lancelot, take heed, honest Gobbo, or as aforesaid, honest Lancelot Gobbo, do not run, scorn running with thy heels. But my conscience says to me to take care of before running, honest Lancelot Gobbo, do not run away from the Jew. Here the fiend, the devil, is advising him to run away from Shylock, and the conscience is asking him to stay back and serve Shylock. Well, the most courageous fiend bids me back. Vaya, says the fiend. Away, says the fiend. For the heaven, rouse up a brave mind, says the fiend, and run. Well, the bold devil advises me to move, to run away from here. Go, says the fiend. Run away, says the fiend. For heaven's sake, awaken a brave mind and run away. Well, my conscience hanging about my neck of my heart says very wisely to me, my honest friend Lancelot, being an honest man's son, or rather an honest woman's son. Well, my conscience says, Lancelot, budge not. But my conscience, clinging close to my heart, says, my honest friend Lancelot, and since you are the son of an honest man, or rather son of an honest woman, you should not move. You should not run away. Budge, says the fiend. Go away, says the fiend. Budge not, says my conscience. Do not go away, says my conscience. Conscience, say I, you counsel well. Conscience, I tell you, you advise very well. Fiend, say I, you counsel well. The devil, I tell you, you too counsel well. You too advise well. To be ruled by my conscience, I should stay with the Jew, my master, who, God bless the mark, is a kind of devil. If I listen to my conscience, I have to stay with my master Shylock, Jew, who is a kind of a devil himself. And To run away from the Jew, I should be ruled by the fiend, who, saving your reverence, is the devil himself. Saving your reverence, it means, since Lancelot is using the word devil for Shylock, so therefore he asks for an apology from the audience. Lancelot says that if he runs away from Shylock, he will be ruled by the fiend, the devil again, who is a devil himself. Certainly, the Jew is the very devil incarnation, and in my conscience is but a kind of hard conscience to offer to counsel me to stay with the Jew. And certainly the Jew, Shylock, is a devil in human form. And to speak truly of my conscience is a very difficult conscience, by advising me to stay with the Jew, the devil. The fiend gives me more friendly counsel, and the advice of the fiend, the devil, is very friendly. I will run, fiend. My heels are at your commandment. I will run. So therefore, fiend, I will run. My heels will listen to your commandment. Enter old Gobbo with a basket. Old Gobbo is Lancelot's father, who is very old and half blind. He brings a basket with him, which is meant to be a present for Shylock, that is Lancelot's master. Gobbo: Master, young man, you, I pray you, which is the way to master Jews? So, master, young man, I request you to tell me the way to master Jew, that is Shylock's house. Lancelot: Aside. Aside means here Lancelot is speaking to the audience, and whatever he speaks cannot be heard by the other characters present on the stage. O heaven, this is my two begotten father. O heaven, this is my father who did beget me, who being more than sand blind, high gravel blind, who is more than half blind, actually more than half blind, knows me not, cannot recognize me. I will try confusions with him, and I will try out an experiment to confuse him. Gobbo: Master, young gentleman, I pray you, which is the way to master Jew? So, master, young gentleman, I request you to tell me the way to Shylock's house. Lancelot: Turn up on your right hand at the next turning. Turn to your right hand when you come to the next turning. But at the next turning or fall on your left. Then at the next turning, turn to your left. Marry, at the very next turning, turn off no hand, but turn down indirectly to the Jew's house. And by Mother Mary, I tell you, then at the next turning, do not turn any side, you will enter the Jew's house. By speaking this way, Lancelot is trying to confuse old Gobbo with the direction of Shylock's house. Gobbo: By God's own tees, it will be a hard way to hit. By God, saint, it will be a difficult way to find. Can you tell me whether one Lancelot that dwells with him, dwell with him or not? Can you tell me that a certain man called Lancelot, who used to stay with him, stays with him anymore or not? Lancelot: Talk you of young Master Lancelot? Are you talking of the young master named Lancelot? Aside: Mark me now, how will I raise the water? Again he talks to audience and says, look at me, how I will make him cry. Talk you of young Master Lancelot? Now for the last line, he turns back to old Gobbo and tells him, are you talking of the young master who is called Lancelot? Gobbo: No, master, sir, but a poor man's son. He is not to be called a master, he is a poor man's son. His father, though I say it, is an honest, exceedingly poor man. And his father, though I myself is saying it, he is an honest man and very poor. And God be thanked well to live, and God should be thanked that he still leads a good life. Launcelot. Well, let his father be what a will, we talk of young Master Launcelot. Well, no matter what his father may be, we are talking of the young master named Launcelot. Gobbo. Your worship, friend, and Launcelot, sir. Your worship, I'm talking of the young Launcelot. Launcelot. But I pray you, ergo, old man, ergo. I beseech you, talk you of young Master Launcelot. The word ergo means therefore. Launcelot, he doesn't know the meaning of this word. He is just using this word to confuse his father, old Gobbo. I request you, are you talking of Master Launcelot? Gobbo. Of Launcelot, ain't please your mastership. Yes, I'm talking of Launcelot, if it pleases you, sir. Launcelot. Ergo, Master Launcelot, talk not of Master Launcelot, father, for the young gentleman, according to fates and destinies, and such odd saying, the sisters three, and such branches of learning, is indeed deceased, or as you would say in plain terms, gone to heaven. So if you talk of Master Launcelot, do not talk of him, father, because that young gentleman, according to fates and destinies, or to speak in plain language, is gone to heaven. He is dead. So here Launcelot speaks in a very confusing manner to confuse his father. Gobbo. Married, the boy was the very staff of my age, my very prop. God should not have done that. That boy was the only support of my old age. Launcelot. Aside. Do I look like a cudgel or a hovel post, a staff or a prop? Do you know me, father? Do I look like a short stick which is used as a support, or the main timber which is used for supporting a house? Do you know me, father? Father, do you recognize me? Gobbo. Alack the day, I know you not, young gentleman. But I pray you, tell me, is my boy, God rest his soul, alive or dead? Alas, I do not know you, young gentleman. But I request you to tell me, my boy Launcelot, may his soul rest in peace. Is he dead or alive? Launcelot. Do you not know me, father? Do you really don't recognize me, father? Gobbo. Alack, sir, I am sand blind. I know you not. Alas, sir, I am half blind. I cannot see you. Therefore, I cannot recognize you. Launcelot. Nay, indeed, if you had your eyes, you might of knowing me. It is a wise father that knows his own child. Now, indeed, even if you were quite good with your eyes, you might have failed to recognize me, because it is only a wise father who can recognize his own son. Well, old man, I will tell you news of your son. Give me your blessing. Launcelot kneels before his father and says, give me your blessing. I'll tell you the news of your son. Truth will come to light. Murder cannot be hid long. A man's son may, but in the end, truth will come out. So truth will be revealed. A murder cannot be hidden for a long time. A man's son can be hidden, but at the end, truth will be revealed. Gobbo. Pray you, sir, stand up. I am sure you are not Launcelot, my boy. I request you, sir, to stand up, because I am sure you are not Launcelot, my boy. Launcelot. Pray you, let's have no more fooling about it. I request you, let's not fool around anymore, but give me your blessing, but bless me. I am Launcelot, your boy, that was, your son, that is, your child, that shall be. So it's me, Launcelot, who is your son, and who was always your son, and will remain your son in future. Gobbo, I cannot think you are my son. I cannot believe that you are my son. Lancelot, I know not what I shall think of that. I really do not know what to say regarding that. But I am Lancelot, the Jew's man, and I am sure Marjorie, your wife, is my mother. But I am Lancelot, Shylock's servant, and I am very much sure that Marjorie, who is your wife, is my mother. Gobbo, her name is Marjorie indeed. I will be sown if thou be Lancelot, thou art mine own flesh and blood. And for sure your mother name is Marjorie. And I swear, if you are Lancelot, you are my own son. Lord worshipped might he be. Lord, may Lord praised for this. What a beard hast thou got? Thou hast got more hair on thy cheek than Dobbin, my fill horse, has on his tail. You have got more hair grown on your chin than my horse Dobbin, he has on his tail. Lancelot, rising, getting up on his heel. It should seem then that Dobbin's tail grow backward. Then it should seem that Dobbin's tail on Dobbin's hair, it grows backward. I'm sure he had more hair on his tail than I have off my face when I last saw him. And I'm sure Dobbin has got more hair on his tail than my face when I last saw him. Gobbo, Lord, how art thou changed? How dost thou and thy master agree? I have brought him a present. How agree you now? O Lord, how much you have changed. How do you and your master get along? How is your relationship now? I have brought him a present. Lancelot, well, well, but for mine own part, as I have set up my rest to run away, so I will not rest till I have run some ground. Well, well, as far as I am concerned, I have made up my mind to run away from here, and I will not rest unless I have covered some distance. My master's a very Jew. Give him a present, give him a halter. My master is truly a Jew. You want to give him a present? Instead, you give him a halter, that is a rope to hang himself with. I am famished in his service. You may tell every finger I have with my rib. I am starved in his service, and you can count with your finger the bones that I have in my rib. Father, I am glad you are come. Give me your present to one Master Bassanio, who indeed gives rare new liveries. Father, I am happy that you have come here. Give your present to Master Bassanio, who gives his servant fine new uniform. I will run as far as God has any ground. If I cannot serve him, I will run as far as I can. O rare fortune, here comes the man. To him, Father, for I am a Jew, if I serve the Jew any longer. O splendid fortune, the man is coming here, Bassanio is coming here. Give him the present, Father. I will be called a Jew if I serve Shylock any longer. So here Lancelot requests his father, old Gobbo, to request Bassanio to let Lancelot serve him. So with this, I end the explanation of the first part of Act 2, Scene 2. You will find explanation of the rest of the scene in the next video. Thank you.